Welcome back to another episode. Today I'm going to show you how to create a contact form for your WordPress powered website. Now obviously you want your website visitors to communicate with you either through social media or through a contact form. By default, WordPress does not have a contact form built in, but we can use a plugin for that functionality. So we're going to go to our dashboard, we're going to go to plugins and add new, and then in the search field we're going to type out contact form 7, press return or enter, and then we're going to see we have the contact form 7 plugin right here. It's active in over 1 million WordPress installations, has a lot of good reviews, recently updated. If you want to view more details, you can click here, but we're going to install the plugin now. Then we're going to activate it. Once you activate it, you're going to see you have this other contact link over here in the admin sidebar. So by default, it comes with one contact form already created for you. So if you just wanted to use the one that's comes by default, you could just copy the shortcode. Very simple to do. Just copy that. And we're going to go to the front of our website. And I'm going to go to this contact page here. Going to edit it. And then I'm going to paste that shortcode right there. I'll update the page. And then I'm going to view the page. And now you see we have the contact form. We have the your name field, your email, subject, your message, and the send button. This will work for the vast majority of people. It's very simple to use. Out of the box, it comes with a default short code that you can use for your contact forms. But if you want to customize it and if you want to add some additional fields, that's also very easy to do. So you go back to the dashboard. We go back to that contact form right there. We could either create a new contact form by clicking here, or we could just edit the one that we just pasted there. But I'm going to add a new contact form. I'm going to call this one contact form 2. All right, so we're going to look at the options it has. If we look in this section here, we have 4 tabs. The first one is for the form itself. And if you look at the HTML here, this is what a regular HTML form would look like. You have your label, opening and closing tags. You have the text that's presented in the contact form itself with the required. And then we have this right here. So this is identifying the field. And then we have the same thing for the email, same thing for the subject, and for the your message. But let's say you also wanted to have a telephone number. We can copy this whole entire snippet right there, give it some space, paste it. We're going to now title this your telephone number. And then we're going to want to delete this information here because now we're going to add in the telephone option right here. But you're going to want to leave your cursor in that location. You click on telephone. You can choose to make it required or not. This is the name of the field itself. You can give it a default value if you want. I'm going to insert the tag. All right, so we're going to save this now. And we'll move on to the next section, which is the mail section. Now, this is where it's going to. It's going to your email address, whatever your admin email address is, from the individual that put in their name here, and then the subject, any additional headers you want to use, and then the message from the person themselves, from your name, the person's name, email address, subject, your subject, and then the message body itself. But now we also have to add the telephone parameter. You're going to see here the contact form 7 plugin highlights this in a darker format. These are grayed out, and this one is the one that we have to now copy that, and then I'm going to paste it right here underneath your message, paste it. And then now we'll be able to get that filled out as well. So I'm going to save that option and that's done. So now we have all the fields filled out properly. You see that now this is grayed out because we have included it in the message body itself. And the same can be done for any of these other options. You would just highlight on one of these snippets here, these sample snippets. You would paste it wherever you want it to come in the order. And then you would choose you would have the cursor located right in between these opening and closing label tags. And then you would choose whichever option you want. Then you would save it and then go to the mail section and make sure you include it inside the message body. And then these are the messages that a person will receive based on the situation of them filling out the contact form. So if they are successful, they'll get this message. If the message failed, they'll get this message right here. And then there's some other messages as well. There's a lot of them, so just take a moment, take a look at it. And if you want to change the language here, you can do that just by typing in your information and just make sure you save at the bottom. If you want to add additional settings, you can do that here. You can go to their additional settings page. And then these are the options you have. All right, so just save everything, any changes you've made, just save them. And then save the form itself. And then now you have this short code right here. You can just click on it and then copy. We're going to go back to that same contact page. I'm going to edit the page now. Remove that short code and paste in the new short code. Update the page, view it. And now we see that we have it here. Okay, so we have the your name, email address, telephone number, subject, your message, and the send button right there. So that's really a simple way to create a contact form for your WordPress powered website. Just go to plugins, add a new plugin, choose the contact form 7, and then if you want to customize them, or if you want to use the default one, you'll have that option right here. You could always just take the information and then use the snippets of code. Then you have these options here. If you notice, we did have it required for the telephone number. So we're going to just take this out, save it, and then let's go back to the front end, go to the contact form, and now it's not required. So that's pretty much it. This is a very good plugin to use. It's very popular. It's very effective. It's customizable. You can create as many contact forms as you want, and it just works. It's one of the most well-reviewed plugins, and there's a lot of documentation about it. And as you can see, it's a nice, easy way to create a contact form for your WordPress-powered website. Hopefully you enjoyed this episode where I demonstrated how to use the Contact Form 7 plugin to create a very easy-to-use contact form for your WordPress website. If you enjoyed the video, give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe because I'll be giving you more tips and tricks on how to manage your WordPress-powered website. Thanks for watching. Take care.